Few families in this state have experienced the burden, the trials and the tribulations and the responsibility of governing Queensland as John Bjelke-Petersen has. His mother was a senator for Queensland for over 10 years and his father, Queensland's longest serving premier. No one knows more than John what needs to be done in Queensland to bring back the prosperity we all deserve. John demonstrated the courage and commitment that he and his family had to Queensland when he resigned from the LNP because he couldn't go along with what Newman was doing. He leads us today to reclaim the mantle of government in this state. Today, we are here to follow John's leadership and to give him our support. Please give him a big welcome, our state leader and candidate for Callide, the next Premier of Queensland, John Bjelke-Petersen.
For your kind words, and I guess I'd like to address the men and women of Queensland. Across this state, Newman is allowing them to poison the water table, to destroy the future of regional Queensland, because Newman and his henchmen don't care about what happens in the bush. Coal seam gas extraction could poison our water table. Coal seam gas needs to stop right now, until proper safeguards and procedures can be put in place to ensure the safety of the rural sector and the welfare of our children. Their lives must come first before anything else. What's the point of destroying the land and its ability to hold stock for a 30-year short-term gain? Pummer United stands for the people of Queensland, and any government we serve in will put the interests of all Queenslanders and their children before any short-term gain. Many people have forgotten how and why the Newman government was elected in 2012. It was because the Labor Party wanted to sell our assets. That's right, the Labor Party, who now attacks the Newman government for following their policies. There is no difference between the LNP and the Labor Party. Yeah. They both want to sell Queensland's hospitals, ports and schools and power stations. It has taken 150 years of successive Queensland governments to build up our assets so that each of us could enjoy the benefits we have now living in Queensland. Successive generations have toiled, passing down from one generation to the next, building on what has been achieved in the past for all of us, so that we can be secure in the knowledge that in the future, our children and our grandchildren will have an even better future. Now Newman wants to privatise Queensland's assets. If he can't manage them and make them work, why doesn't he just resign now? The answer is because Newman knows the people who support him can make a lot of money from the sales of our hospitals, our schools, our ports and power stations. If you think you're paying a lot for electricity now, imagine what you will pay if Newman has his way. The agents, lobbyists and other consultants friendly to the LNP can make a killing in the process. Newman will kill the Queensland economy. No one buys anything unless they make a profit from it. Businesses will only buy Queensland's assets if they can make money out of it. That will happen by charging you, the people of Queensland, more. After spending tens of millions of dollars of taxpayers' dollars on Newman found out 86% of Queenslanders did not want to sell their assets. So he devised a scheme to privatise. The arrogance Newman demonstrated by these actions proves once and for all it is that he doesn't care about what people think. Absolute power corrupts and corrupts absolutely. Newman has used that power against the very people who supported him and elected him. Now more than ever, we have to move to ensure that it doesn't happen again. Palmer United will use its seats in Parliament to achieve the re-establishment of the upper house in Queensland so that we can ensure checks and balances are in place for all legislation. We need to prioritise regional development in Queensland. Through the PUP senators, we will push for the reintroduction of zonal taxation scheme so that there is incentive for people and businesses to move out into regional areas. Under Newman, regional Queensland has suffered. Families have lost their farms and businesses, and the suicide rate has increased due to a lack of government support. There are many people on the ground working hard to support these farmers and businesses, but there needs to be a lot more done to support them. Young Queenslanders have lost the ability to purchase a farm, to get a start and provide the export income and food security the state desperately needs to sustain us all. Palmer United will seek to introduce the first farm buyers grant, which will provide a capital contribution equivalent to the first home buyers grant, but at a concessional interest rate, loans for the first 5 years. This will act as a catalyst to allow the state's agriculture's next generation to get going again and to create real demand in the country. We cannot tolerate Australians dying in our corridors of our hospitals. Healthcare is declining in every hospital of the state. We know our healthcare workers, such as the nurses, are doing the very best they can do under the circumstances. But we know medical staff are overworked and capital infrastructure is not up to projected increases of our ageing population. Why do patients, like I met the other day, suffering from diabetes, have to travel long distances for basic weekly treatment down south? This should be available in our regional hospitals for that treatment. We will never demolish a hospital and sell the land off to property developers like the Newman government is doing. Palmer United will demand that in any government, of which I am a member, will not sell any schools, hospitals or police stations. Thank you. Palmer United will prioritise upgrades of our hospitals in areas of Queensland which have been neglected for many years. The Maribyrnong Hospital has been significantly downgraded and it needs to be restored to its former capability. We need to review medical care throughout Queensland as a whole. The Kingaroy Hospital, for example, was established in the Second World War. It is aged and falling apart in many areas. Healthcare workers in regional Queensland are overworked and understaffed. We need to carry out an urgent review to ensure that people are not dying because the government has turned a blind eye to the needs of the people. We need to provide more funding to education in this country. As Clive Palmer said, a free nation can rise no higher than a standard of excellence set by our schools and colleges and universities. Ignorance, illiteracy, unskilled workers and school dropouts, those are the failures of an education system in the past that breed failures in our social and economic system. Delinquency, unemployment, chronic dependency are a result of a waste of human resource, a loss of productivity, an increase of tax-supported benefits. The cost of only 1 year's income due to unemployment is more than the total cost of 12 years' education. Failure to improve our education performance is not only poor social policy, it is poor economic policy. At the start of the last century, only 10% of adults had a high school education or university education. Today, such an education has become a requirement of an increasing number of jobs. Palmer United believes we must inject extra funds into the education system. It is time to invest in ourselves. If we don't have confidence in ourselves, who will have confidence in us? We must educate our children, our most valuable resource. We must make it possible for those with talent to go to university, no matter where they live or under what circumstances they live. This is why our ability to compete internationally and to expand our export capabilities is so important. Our universities must be given incentives to compete internationally. They were once one of Australia's key exports, and they can be again. Palmer United believes Queensland needs more doctors, nurses, teachers, and police. Once in government, we will set about the important task of restoring government to be able to provide the level of service necessary for all Queenslanders, regardless of where they live. For too long, Queenslanders have lacked incentive and confidence in the economy, but we want to change that. We know that all of us can make Queensland a better place if we pull together. We find that Queenslanders are limited in what they do because of the burden of taxation and the high cost of living. Incentives have been lost, and with no activity, there is no growth in our economy, and our economy continues to decline and the revenue shrinks. And before we know it, the government wants to close our schools and privatise our hospitals. The lack of incentive is behind the problem we face in Queensland today. Business happens because of networks. Queensland needs to encourage our business leaders and Queenslanders to interact and to come up with ideas to make the most of our commercial opportunities. We in the Palmer United Party want to maximise that because it creates jobs, opportunities, and boosts the economy. And let's face it, we are all investors in Queensland. When my father was Premier, this state was the number one state in Australia. Everyone wanted to live in Queensland. It had the strongest, most vibrant economy. We have to create more jobs, economic activity, and we have to realise Queensland competes with all other states. My father's government abolished death duties, and as a result, people and investment flowed to Queensland and the state boomed. There were jobs, and more jobs for all Queenslanders. Queensland needs to take the lead again. Palmer United will abolish payroll tax in Queensland. And when we do this, our state will become the powerhouse of the nation. Companies will move their offices and their activities from Sydney and Melbourne, and Queensland will boom. There is no better way to create employment in Queensland than to offer real incentives for the people to do business right here in Queensland. If we want to make a difference, support me in bringing about the change, and our children will be the winners. Such a change will allow Queenslanders to address the real serious problems that all Queenslanders and business face. Our high cost base and our high cost of living, which has grown under the Newman government and has been brought about primarily by poor government decisions and policies. Firstly, the cost of electricity in Queensland is at its highest ever. And this is at a time when world coal prices are at their lowest for a decade. In real terms, this illustrates more than anything how incompetent the Newman government is. We can bring down the cost of electricity, and the Palmer United will do it by taking control of the network that currently charges more than the cost of generating power to all Queenslanders. Townsville is a long way from Brisbane, Cairns even further. There needs to be a Minister for North Queensland in the Cabinet who will be vocal in representing the views of our northern neighbours in all critical decisions of government. This will ensure all areas of Queensland are working together as one and supporting each other. Too many times, North Queensland has been forgotten by previous governments. Here on the Sunshine Coast, we can do much more. Palmer United will support the development of the Maroochydore Airport into an international airport. I will work with Senator Lazarus and Senator Wang and the local member for the House of Representatives, Clive Palmer, to achieve Commonwealth support for such an airport. Together, we will boost our tourism industry, create jobs. This will result in many construction jobs. The Gold Coast, the Barrier Reef, Western, Central and North Queensland can offer so much to the world. Queensland must be actively promoting the state internationally and within Australia. Rather than having a tourism minister like in Newman's government that rarely leaves the state unless she's on holidays. Maintenance of roads is now under the Newman government, carried out by contractors. This has put Queensland's lives at risk. Palmer United will restore the maintenance of main roads to the Department of Main Roads. Abbott, along with Newman's support, has increased the cost of fuel by raising fuel excise levies. This penalises Queensland as the most major decentralised state. We will use our numbers in the Senate to reverse this decision. Yeah. Palmer United believes in the independence of our judiciary and of the police. Under Newman, the Queensland Police Force has become the LNP enforcer of Newman's policy. Last week, we saw the arrest of an individual because of a message he wore on his T-shirt. The Queensland Police needs to stay out of the political debate. There are few times in history when a generation has an opportunity to make a difference to their lives, to shape the destiny of their communities. This is such a moment, and for this reason, I am here leading a strong team that can make a difference to our state and its prosperity. However you may have voted in the past, now more than ever, It is important to think before you vote. To mindlessly cast a vote without accepting a real responsibility is an insult to democracy. If you are happy with all that is being done now, happy with Abbott and Newman, if you think that what's being done now is enough, is sufficient for your future and your families, then go Newman's way. But if you believe, like I do, that there is so much more we can achieve together, then put your support behind Palmer United and make Queensland all it could be. When my father was first elected to government, his neighbour called him the next morning and said, "Well, Joe, yesterday you were my neighbour and friend. Now you're my servant." And I know these people sitting with me here today as the candidates for Palmer United Party are ready to serve you, the people of Queensland. Together we can and we will achieve the extraordinary. God bless Queensland.